In 1975, Argent released their sixth studio album, Circus, and from it, the track Highwire.
Thank you.
suddenly a bit of a Hammond-like tone toward the end that wasn't heard throughout the rest of the piece. Yeah, that was Highwire by Argent, the second track and the most epic from their 1975 release Circus, their first without Russ Ballard, but taking his place on guitar anyway is John Grimaldi, who's quite a player, as it you could hear there. And Ron Argent playing as big of an arsenal as ever. He's credited with organ, piano, electric piano, Fender Rhodes, obviously, Mellotron, vocals, and synthesizer, Moog, etc. I thought I was hearing an ARP at one point, too, but let's get to my notes here. Well, it began with this like Fender Rhodes melody in G, with an emphasis on the fifth, the D, mostly, and then I swear like an open two, an A in there. It had a real kind of slanted feel to it. But I couldn't quite pick up like a major seventh. I almost was thinking, it tensed up with this drum roll about 40 seconds in, and this soaring lead and smoky synth tone, which heralded the verse. And there was like this lucid vocal about daring circus stunts, kind of a contradiction, really. Like he's just speaking kind of this like, singing in this like drugged out, kind of hazy tone about, maybe that's kind of his impression of, well, no, the, you know, people who actually go on high wires have to be really focused. They can't be, you know, taking hits before they go up there, you know, to ease the nerves or whatever. That's just not what it's, but, so this is quite, let's just say, I don't think that's his impression either. Maybe that's part of the joke. Anyway, there's this soaring collisions of synth and guitar. And then the guitar soloing gets more scaly amid the foggy, misty synth tones, courtesy of Argent. And then the soloing becomes more searing, courtesy of Grimaldi. And it was at this point that the track started to remind me of what Manfred Mann's Earth Band were doing around this time. Like on albums like Nightingales and Bombers. Like that track, boom, 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 that instrumental on side two. Or a lot of the material on The Roaring Silence. Thinking like This Side of Paradise, or Starboard. Drowning on Dry Land from Watch, the midsection. Suddenly at around 3:40, there was a middle eight break to this F centered descent, like a sharp break from song proper. And then, which modulated through different chordal centers as it advanced. And it was at this point where I heard this synth tone come in that I thought was an ARP. Although, they don't have an ARP listed on here. They have Moog, but it was a tone that was very similar. And I actually looked right into the lens and like pointed. It reminded me of the sound heard on the theme to In Search Of by Rinder and Lewis. I also thought of Starbird by Manfred Mann's Earth Band. Or, heck, I thought of Starbuck. In particular, Moonlight Feels Right. Yeah. All from around the same time. And then, let's see, at 5:45, a faster iteration of that F section suddenly appeared with brisk drumming and wailing fast solos on guitar, Grimaldi, and dusty cymbals. And then as time went on, the guitar soloing seemed to have been doubled, between Grimaldi and John Verity. It seemed like they were kind of like playing off of one another. There was some panning of that speaker to speaker over this like milky, murky Rhodes underbed. And then at around 7 minutes in, the intro G melody from the start of the song reinstated. This time on guitar, like near near. And then it went back and forth between that and the F, so the last section we just heard, the brisk, I love it towards in those parts of the song where you know that they're maybe climaxing, where they start to throw different, they start to go back and forth between different prior movements in the song, just kind of like recapitulating everything, like doing kind of like a, just a recap of everything that we had heard. And then the verse returns for the final, minute or so, and then we just go that outro and those sustained keyboard tones that lead us out, including that Hammond tone, which I don't see that listed, but there was definitely a lot of Mellotron throughout that piece, a lot of Fender Rhodes, and it says Moog, maybe some ARP, that wasn't, it just says organ. Manfred Mann's Earth Band, of course, very comparable to Argent, since the core members both dated back to like the Beat era, like 1964, the British invasion. Both have ties to the British invasion, and both went on to play kind of this mixture of like spacey, fusion-y, symphonic, hard rock during the 70s. Similar to like, bands like Yes and Genesis, except also more of like a blues rock basis that would creep up at times. More indebted to the blues rock boom of the mid-60s, that influence that would still, as Edward McCann pointed out in Rocking the Classics, it only made sense since they were rooted in the Beat era, when they were doing, back when bands were doing a lot of R&B covers and such. Highwire, one of the highlights off a great album, came out in 1975 by Argent Circus. Their first of two post-Ballard albums. Counterpoints was the second, coming out, I guess, in later 1975, although I used to think of that as a 1976 album. Some of the press, the version I had the U.S. version that came out in 1976, but it first came out toward the end of 1975, I guess, in Germany, but I actually see a scan of a label that confirms a 1975 pressing. So 1975, a big year for Argent. And both albums very full of these passages with lots of smoky keyboards and fast, rapid-fire guitar work and such, and songs oftentimes blending into one another, and those kind of hazy, lucid, druggy vocals and such. Like a spacey, kind of like a mixture of lounge and space music, and that whole like Super 8 kind of dim lighted feel. Just very mid-70s. Makes you want to think. Sometimes it just, I get into that mid-70s vibe and aura, and it just makes me wish that the changes of the future never even happened. But you can always just plug in and drift away to it. I get into a similar, altered state in that video I did about 15 months ago now to This Side of Paradise by Manfred Mann's Earth Band off The Roaring Silence. Go look up that one. And this is the third time I've featured Argent now, yeah, having already covered two tracks from the Ballard era. Anyway, for more rubies and sapphires from the catalog of Argent, see the directory of albums by English A artists linked in the description below. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share that video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the track we just heard. The layers, the intensity, the interplay, the guitar soloing, the keyboard sounds, the misty, hazy intensity and feel and vibe of it all. And the lyrics, if you caught anything you wanted to make a comment on. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most air travel tram expert, signing off.